Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I am going to discuss about 8085 microprocessor, which is in the paper PHS504 electronics in the unit, first unit, topic basics of microprocessor 8085. First of all, I'll discuss about basics of microprocessor. Microprocessor 8085 microprocessor is a processor which is used to study about all the processors. So 8085 is a basic processor which is designed to study about all the functions of advanced processors. Of course, there are many advanced processors, but still the 8085 is used as a basic processor to understand all the functions based on its internal design. So the word microprocessor came from micro and processor. It consists of two open parts, micro and processor. Processor means the device that processes all the data. And the micro means a single chip fabricated, all the components are fabricated inside that chip. The microprocessor is a programmable device that takes some numbers as the input, performs some arithmetic and logical operations on them according to the program stored in the memory, and produces other numbers as a result. So, to study about microprocessors, before that we should know something about the microcomputer, microprocessor and microcontroller. What are the differences between them? So, microcomputer is a computer with a microprocessor as its CPU, and it also includes memory, I/O device, etc. Microprocessor is a single IC which includes ALU registers and control unit inside that. But coming to the microcontroller, microcontroller is a single IC again which includes microprocessor. Microprocessor requires some memory and I/O inside the same chip. So coming to the functions of microprocessor. To study about microprocessors, any microprocessors, we should know some functions which is performed by the microprocessor. There are three different functions which is performed by the microprocessor. That is, first one is microprocessor initiated operation, second one is internal operation, and third one is peripheral or externally initiated operations. Coming to the first part, that is microprocessor initiated operation. The microprocessor initiated operations are to perform, it performs four different operations. That is, there are four microprocessor initiated operations. First one is memory read operation, which is used to read data stored in memory. Next is memory write operation, which does writing the data into memory, or saving some data into memory. Then comes I/O read, that is reading the input data or taking the input data, and I/O write, sending then some data to the output device. All these are initiated by the microprocessor. That's why it comes under microprocessor initiated operations. Now I'm going to the microprocessor initiated operation first. To discuss with microprocessor initiated operation, that is memory read, memory write, I/O read and I/O write, to communicate this microprocessor with the memory or I/O device, any I/O device, we can call that as peripheral. To communicate with this, the microprocessor need to perform three different operations. That is, first one is identify the peripheral or memory location, then transfer the data and instructions, whatever is stored in the memory. For that, timing and control signals is to be given, that is providing the timing or synchronization signals. These are the three steps to be followed. So, to discuss about the these three functions to be steps to be followed, we should know the bus structure of any microprocessor. Now I am coming to the 8085 microprocessor bus structure. Here the 8085 is an 8-bit microprocessor because it contains a 8-bit data bus, or we can say that which manipulates 8-bit of data at a time. So 8085 bus structure consists of different buses. First of all, what is a bus? Bus is a communication path used to transfer the information such as data or address, or sometimes the control signals also. So here in this diagram we can see the 8085 data bus structure, or bus structure simply. Here 8085 microprocessing unit or microprocessor is connected to a memory input device and output device. Even sometimes we can connect this to real world also. So here the communication between all these are done by using some communication paths or communication lines, group of communication lines. They are known as the buses. There are three different buses. One is address bus, and another one is data bus, and finally the control bus. So coming to the address bus first. Address bus is just in the diagram you can see that address bus is mentioned as A0 through A15. So address bus is 16 bits, and which is coming from microprocessor and going to peripheral or memory. So it is unidirectional. And then coming to the data bus, it's given below. Data bus is an 8-bit data bus. You can see D0 through D7. So it is 8-bit data bus, and you can see that the data bus can be used to transfer the data between memory or IO device, whatever it may be, to processor and vice versa. So that's why it is bidirectional. And there is a set of lines used to control the entire operation, which is known as the control bus. And they are single buses which is used to control all the operations. That also comes from processor to the memory or IO device. Address buses, as I said, it's unidirectional, 16-bit size. Its capacity of addressing, it has the capacity of addressing 2 to the power 16, that's equal to 65,536, which is equal to 64K memory locations, where K indicates 1024. And as I said, it has the capability of addressing 64K memory locations. It starts from 0 to 65,536, which is, we have to represent which in hexadecimal, that is, it starts from 00002 FFFF. Why we are representing this in hexadecimal? Because the processor understands, or processor, any digital system as a digital computer understands binary numbers as the data which is to be processed. So when we represent all the numbers in terms of binary, bigger numbers in terms of binary, there may be chance of some mistakes. That's why we represent all the data in terms of hexadecimal numbers. Okay. Now coming to the data bus. Data bus is bidirectional, as I said, and it's 8-bit size, and it can able to manipulate 2 to the power 8, which is equal to 256 numbers using the 8-bit data bus. So the data ranges from 0 to 255. As a whole, 256 numbers, which should be represented in hexadecimal as 00 to FF.